Hello friends, this is Shravan. This is my YouTube channel Civil Engineering by Shravan. To subscribe my channel, click on subscribe button and click on bell icon for more interesting updates. In this video lecture, I will explain you complete ETAP software and complete building design within 1 hour. So initially I will show you the plan for that respected complete building design. So click on this PDF option. So this is my plan, which is consisting of two portions of apartments in each floor. So I will consider the same plan for G+4 building. So let us consider the number of floors equals to 5, and each floor will be consisting of 5 multiplied by 3. So initially I am taking the number of columns for this building is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Again in Y direction it will be consisting of 1, 2, 3. The total number of columns for this respected building are 6 multiplied by 3, which is equals to 80 numbers. So here I am taking first column to second column, center to center distance between column is 4 meter, and second column to third column is 4 meter. Again I am taking third column to fourth column is 2 meter, and fourth column to fifth column is 3 meter, and fifth column to last column is 4 meter. So initially we need to take the length of the building, which is equals to 4 plus 4 8, 8 plus 2 10, 10 plus 3 which is equals to 13, 13 plus 4, 17. In the same way, we have to take the vertical direction distance also. So here I am taking in vertical direction, the first column to second column distance, let us take it as 3 meter. Again, I am taking second column to third column distance is 4 meter, which is equals to 7 meter. This is applicable for G+4 building plan. Okay. So I will take same particulars for the respected G+4 building structure. So for that, initially we need to click on the ETAP software. So select your ETAP software here, double click on it. The software will be open like this. So initially we need to click on file option here, click on new model here. So click on new model. So initially we need to select the initialization options here. So it will be consisting of user saved, user default settings, user settings from model file, and user built-in settings. So from this respected three options, we need to select the last one, which is consisting of your user built-in settings with. Okay, so it will be consisting of display units option, steel section database and steel section design code, concrete design code. So as per the considerations, we are doing this project in Indian standard system. So we need to take the values as well as your respected codal provisions as per the Indian standard system only. So here I am taking display units in metric SI system. Again, I am taking the steel section design database as per the IS code. So here I am selecting the unit code as Indian standard system, Indian. Again, I am selecting the steel design code is also Indian, which is consisting of IS 800-2007. Now we have to select the concrete design code here. Again, here also we need to select the code IS Indian standard system 456. So after that, click on OK option. Now it will open your respected new model quick templates option like this. So it will be consisting of your grid dimensions data and story dimensions data. Grid dimensions data is nothing but the center to center distance between the column for each floor. Story dimensions data is nothing but the data which is related to the number of floors and floor to floor height. Okay, so it will be consisting of number of grids in x direction, number of grids in y direction, spacing in x direction, spacing in y direction. So as per the plan, it will be consisting of number of lines in x direction are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 here. Okay, so here we have to take the x lines are 6. Again, we have to take the number of lines in y direction, which are equal to 3 here. Why? Because we are taking the two sections. So again we have to enter the spacing in x direction, let us take it as 3, and spacing in y direction, let us take it as 3 for example. So after that it will open your respected 3 options for the 6 number of grids here. So we have to add the data which is related to the center to center distance between the column with varying dimensions. So here I was taken 3 value, which is regular value, which is multiplied by your respected 6, will give you 18 meter. But my building length is not equals to 18 meter, it is equals to 17 meter. So to edit that respected data, we have to select custom grid space option here. So click on edit grid data here. So here you can change the dimensions as per your specification, which is related to the coordinate X, coordinate Z. So here initially we need to enter the data for this respected options. So here I am selecting the first grid will be consisting of 4 meter. Again I am selecting the second grid, which is equals to 4 plus 4, which is equals to 8 here. Again, I am taking third grid length, which is consisting of 8 plus 2, which is equals to 10. Now, I am taking the next grid, which is equals to 10 plus 3, which is having the intensity of 13. Again, I am taking the last grid, which is consisting of 13 plus 4, which is equals to 17 meter. So after that, we have to enter the data, which is related to the y direction grids. So initially, I am selecting the 2 value as 3. Again, I am taking the 3 value as 7. So click on OK. So it will change the grid dimensions data here. So after that, we have to enter the story dimensions data. So here, as per the problem, we have to consider the number of stories are 5. Why? Because we are considered a G plus 4 structure. So 4 plus 1, which is equals to 5. Now we have to select the grid only option here. Okay, click on OK option. So it will open your respected grid options here like this. Okay, so this is the left hand side section window and this is the right hand side section window. Left hand side section window will be consisting of the plan view of the building and right hand side section will be consisting of the 3D view of the building. Okay, so after adding these grid lines, which is related to your G plus 4 building, we need to define the material properties. Material properties is nothing but the grade of the concrete and grade of the steel. Okay. So for that, initially click on define option here, select the material properties. So initially we need to delete all previous properties here. So here I'm selecting this property, click on add new material here. Initially we need to select the Indian standard system code and material will be of concrete section. So here I'm selecting Indian standard system, which is having concrete grade of M30 grade. Click on OK. So after that, we have to click on OK option here. Now we have to add the steel section also. So click on add new material. So it will be consisting of your respected Indian standard system code and material type will be of steel. Again, I am selecting Indian standard system. Click on OK. So but the material property which is related to the steel, it was added with Fe345. But here, as per the definition, we need the value of 500 grade. Let us consider. So here we had to enter the data which is related to the 500 grade. So for that, we had to select the modify show material property data here. Now here we had to change the data from 345 to 500. Again, every value will be same. Click on OK. Click on OK here. So click on OK. Now after defining the material properties, we need to define the beam size and column size for this building. So for that, initially we need to click on define option here. So click on section database, select the frame section. So it will be consisting of the number of sections like this. Initially we need to delete all previous sections. So here I am selecting delete multiple options. So select all previous sections here for this respected structure building. So here I am selecting all my previous section. Click on delete frame sections. So it will be deleted with all previous sections, but at least it is needed to add two properties. So that's why it was added with two sections here. After adding the requirements of our beam size, column size, we will delete this respected property. So initially we need to add the beam size. So click on add new property here. So we need to select the concrete section or steel section or special section or composite section depending upon your requirements. So here, as per my definition, I am considering the RCC building only. So that's why I am selecting rectangular section here. So here we have to give the property name. Initially just I'm taking 0.35 cross 0.35 is the beam size. Again, we have to select the material property as per the grade of the concrete. Now we have to select the depth as well as width of the beam. Okay, so here I am considering depth of the beam is 0.35. Again, width of the beam is 0.35, which is equals to 350 cross 350 intensity values here. Okay, which is related to the section dimensions, 350 cross 350 here. Okay, so after that we have to click on reinforcement option here. Now here we have to select the rebar material which is related to the beam section only. Select the beam here. So again, we have to select the longitudinal bars and lateral bars which is related to the Fe500 grade steel. Click on OK. So it will add your respected properties here like this. Now again, I am selecting the next one is Fe500 grade steel here. Now here I am selecting the top as well as bottom cover will be equal to 50 mm. Click on OK option. So click on OK. Again, in the same way, we have to delete the two properties here. So click on delete multiple options, select this property. Again, I'm selecting this property. Click on delete option. Click on OK. So it was added with only one property, which is related to the beam, which is having the dimensions of 0.35 cross 0.35. So after adding the beam dimensions, we need to add the column dimensions. So initially we need to define the column dimensions also. Add a new property here. Select the concrete material. So now we need to give the name of the column. Select 0.45 cross 0.45 is the column dimensions. Now I am selecting the M30 grade concrete. Now here I am giving the depth as 450. Again width as 450. Now in the same way we have to select the reinforcement here. Click on the reinforcement. Select the column here and change the longitudinal bars and confinemental bars as per the Indian standard code, which is related to the Fe500 gray steel. Again I am selecting this material. Click on add button. Again I am selecting this material. Click on add button. So after that we have to enter the longitudinal bars. So here it was suggested that the cover as 40 mm, which is taken as 10% of the dimensions of the column. So you can modify it as 50 here, and number of bars along 3 direction you can change it to 4, and longitudinal 2 direction bars also 4. So here we had to select the longitudinal bar size, corner bar size. So as per your requirement you can consider the bar sections. Okay, so here I am taking 20 mm bars for longitudinal bars and corner bars. For confinemental bars here I am selecting it as 10 mm bars. Click on OK option. Again click on OK option. So after that we have to click on OK option. Now we have to define the slab thickness for this building. So click on define. So select the section properties. In this we need to select the slab thickness, slab sections. Okay, third option. So select this. So initially we need to delete the property which is related to the default one. So click on add new property here. Now here we need to give the property name. Okay, so slab, let us consider it as 150, and slab material will be related to M30 grade, and we have to select this as membrane section. It will be consisting of shell thin, shell thick membrane and this respected section. So in that we need to consider the membrane only. So after that we have to select the type as slab, and we have to give the thickness as 150 mm. Okay option. So after that we have to select the slab 1 section here. Click on delete property. Click on S option. Click on OK. So after defining the properties which is related to the beam sections, column sections and slab sections, we have to assign those properties for this building. So for that initially we need to change the one story option to the all stories option here. Okay, so here it will be consisting of the option here as one story. Instead of one story option we need to convert that to all stories options. Select all stories option here. Okay, so now we need to assign the beam sections. For assigning the beam sections generally we will have two methods. Okay, now I will explain you the first method. So after that I will explain you the second method. First method is we need to draw the lines. Okay, draw the beams. Okay, so select this respected option, draw beam option. So it will open your respected properties option here like this. So initially we need to check that property whether it is comes under your beam section or column section. Now we have to select the first grid and we have to select the second grid. Okay, so it will assign your beam property here like this. Now we can see the blue lines are indicates your beam sections in each floor. Okay, you can select that blue lines and you can delete it as per your requirements. Okay, so here the first option will be indicates your draw option. Okay, second option will be indicates your fix draw beams option. Okay, so you can select the center point of that respected structure. You can select the beam sections here like this. So it will assign your beam sections like this. Okay, so in this same way you can assign to the respected properties for this building. Okay, so if you are facing any kind of the difficulty for assigning if this respected properties, for that we have another method is also there. So select the second option. Simply you can select the option properties here as per the beam sections. You can drag to the respected properties here. Okay, so it will assign your respected beam sections for this building of G+4. So after that we have to assign the column sections. So for that we have second option is there, which is related to the quick draw columns. You can select this option and you can change the property from beam sections to the column sections, which is of 0.45 cross 0.45. You can select the center point at different positions. Okay, so you can select this center point for this respected structure. Otherwise, we have one more option is there for assigning of the column section for this section, column section for the building. So you can select the I section here. You can drag to the respected model here like this. So it will directly takes your respected node points and it will directly assign your columns here like this. So after that, we have to assign a slab section. So for assigning the slab section, we have three options are there. Individually, I will explain you the usage of that respected three options. So in that first option is draw floors. Okay, select this option and you have to change the property from deck to slab here. So it will be consisting of slab 150 now. Select first point, select second point here, again select third point, again click on fourth point here. Okay, again come to the first point. So it will assign your respected property of slab here like this. Okay, so this is the first method. And second method is drawing the rectangular floors. Okay, so for that initially we need to select the one node point. Again we have to drag to the respected second node point. Okay, in the same way we have third method option also there. So that is related to the quick draw floors option. So select this point, again select next 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 point, again come to the first point. Okay, so this is the procedure to assign the slab section for the building. Okay, so after assigning the slab section, we have to delete all the properties at the base for this respected building. Why? Because it was assigned with the slab sections at the base. We need to delete that respected properties. Okay, so go to select option here, select, so select here, go to select by, so go to select by stories here. So here we have to select the base, click on select option. So it will select all the properties at the base for this building. Now we have to click on delete option. So it will delete all your properties at the base for this building here like this. So after assigning the properties for the structure, initially we need to see this model in rendering view. Okay, so for that we need to click on the rendering view option here. So select the right mark here on the top of the building. So select this. So in this we need to select the object fill options and extrude shells and extrude frames, apply to all windows here, apply, okay here. Okay, now we can see the building model was open here like this, which is consisting of your respected 0.3 x 0.3 beam size and 0.45 x 0.45 is the column size and slab thickness will be consisting of 150 mm. Okay, so after modeling process completed, we need to apply the load cases for this respected structure. Basically, for designing of this respected building, I am considering the load cases which are related to the dead loading condition, live loading condition, seismic loading condition as well as wind loading condition. Okay, initially we need to define that respected load cases. So select define option here, select define option, select load patterns option. Okay, so here it was already added with the dead loading condition as well as live loading condition. So initially I am taking the next load case is earthquake load, which is in x direction condition. Now we have to select the type here, which is related to the seismic loading condition, and we have to select the IS code from the auto lateral load combination. So here I am selecting IS code, which is related to the 1893-2002. Click on add property. Now in the same way we have to add earthquake load, which is in y direction condition. So click on add button. Now I am entering the wind loading x direction condition. Now here we have to select the title as wind. Now we have to select the code as per the Indian standard system. Indian standard system of 875-2015. Click on add. In the same way we have to add the load, which is in y direction condition. Okay, so after adding the properties, we need to modify the data which is related to the seismic loading condition as well as wind loading condition. Basically, seismic load I was considered as per the IS code, which is related to the 1893 code. So as per the IS code, it was suggested that the number of zones will be consisting of 4, which is equals to zone 2, zone 3, zone 4, zone 5, which is having the coefficient factor of 0.1, 0.16, 0.24 and 0.36. You can select any one of the zone as per your considerations. So here I am considering the zone 5 condition, which is placed in medium soil condition. So select earthquake load, which is in x direction condition. So here we have to click on modify lateral load option. Select x direction load case only here. So select x direction load case. Again we have to select the per code value is 0.36. So click on soil type is 2. Again click on OK option. In the same way we have to select Y direction, modify lateral load, In the same way, select in y direction condition only. Again, we have to select the power code value 0.36. So click on OK. Now I am selecting the wind load, which is in x direction condition. Modify lateral load. Now here we have to enter the basic wind speed value, and which is consisting of your different types of terrains like this. So select any one of the terrain here. And importance factor, just I am considering it as 1.15. And risk coefficient is 1, topography coefficient is 1. Okay. So click on modify show option here. So here we have to select the angle of direction for the wind load. So x direction just I am taking with angle is 0 degrees. Click on OK. Again I am selecting OK option. Select wind load in y direction. Modify lateral load. Again I am selecting it as 44, which is comes under your respected terrain category 3, which is having 1.15. And we have to click on modify show option again. Again in the same way we have to enter the y direction. We already know x direction is always perpendicular to y direction, so that's why I am taking it as 90 degrees. Click on OK. So after that we have to click on OK option. So here I was defined the load cases, which is related to the dead loading condition, live loading condition, as well as seismic loading and wind loading condition. Now we have to assign those properties or assign those load cases for this building. So initially we need to apply the dead load for this structure. So initially I am selecting all the building here. So click on assign option. So here we have to select the joint loads. Select the forces here. Again we have to select the add to existing loads option. It will be consisting of three options here, which is related to the add to existing and replace existing and delete existing. Okay. So if you want to add new one, you need to click on add to existing load cases, or if you want to replace the existing load with new intensity, you can select the second option. Otherwise, if you want to delete the intensity, you can select the last one. So here I'm selecting add to existing. Why? Because I'm adding the new load cases here, which is having the factor of coefficient as 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Click on apply, click on OK option. So it will apply your respected self weight for this respected structure. So after that we had to apply the dead load condition for the beam, dead load condition for the column, dead load condition for the slab. So we are already assigned the self weight. So that self weight is only related to the joint member load. Okay, so joint, that is only related to the joint load. Okay, now we have to add the member load for individual members. So initially we need to calculate the intensity of the load. Okay, as per the considerations, we need to calculate the intensity of the load. So here I am taking the dimensions of the beam as 0.35 cross 0.35. We have to multiply this respected value with 25. So it will give the intensity of 3.0625. We have to initially select beams, select by properties. Now here we have to select the frame sections. So select the beam, which is consisting of 0.35 cross 0.35. Click on select. It will select all your members here like this. We have to assign the 3.0625 load for this members only. So click on assign option here. Select frame loads. Select distributed load. And we have to select add to existing load. In this we need to enter the intensity of 3.0625. So click on apply. So click on OK. So it will apply your respected dead load for the beam section. In the same way we have to select the column here. So it will select all your property which is related to the column section. Now we have to calculate the intensity of the load, which is related to the 0.45 cross 0.45 multiplied by your 25. So it will give the intensity of 5.0625 intensity. So click on select option here. So we have to go to assign here. Select assign. Frame line load, distributed load. In this we need to select the dead load, which is add to existing load intensity, which is having 5.0625 is the intensity we need to add for that respected column section. 5.0625. click on apply option, click on OK. So after adding the column dead load, we need to add the slab dead load also. We can calculate the respected intensity with the help of the thickness. 0.15 multiplied by 25, so it will give the intensity of 3.75. So select, go to select option. So select by properties, select by slab sections, select S150 slab, select here. So click on select option here, click on close option here. So it will select all your respected slab sections here. Go to assign, shell area loads, uniform. In this we need to click on add to existing load, which is having the intensity of 3.75 load. So 3.75 is the intensity of the load. Click on apply. So it will apply your respected 3.75 for the slab members only. Okay, so after applying the slab dead loading condition, we have to apply the live load for this building. So for that, we have different options are there, which is related to the selection of all properties and previous section properties, clear property. So if you want to clear the selected object, you can click on the clear. If you wanted to select the previous objects, you can select the previous section option PS. And if you want to select all the building structure, you can select all. Okay. So here I'm selecting the previous section PS here. So it will select all your respected slab sections. So go to assignment option. Shell area load, uniform, change your dead loading condition to the live loading condition, add to existing load with some load intensity of 2.5. Click on apply option, click on OK. So after that we have to apply the seismic loading condition, which is in X direction as well as Y direction. So for that initially we need to select all the structure by using Ctrl A option. So go to click on assign option, shell area loads, we have to select uniform load. Now we have to select the load pattern as per the earthquake load in X direction condition. So here we have to add the new load cases, which is related to the add to existing one. Now here we have to enter the load intensity, which is related to the 50% of the live loading condition. So here I was considered the live loading condition for the building is 2.5. We need to take 2.5 divided by 2, which is equals to 1.25, which is act in global X direction only. Please remember this point. Click on add, close. In the same way, we have to select previous section, which is nothing but the selection of all building. Again, go to assign, shell area load, uniform load. Again, we have to select the earthquake load in Y direction condition, add to existing load with the direction as global Y. Click on apply, click on OK option. So after that, we have to apply the wind load for this respective structure. So initially, I'm selecting all the building. So click on assign option. So click on select shell area load. In this, it will be consisting of wind pressure coefficient here. Select this option. And now we have to enter the wind pressure coefficient 0.86. So click on apply option. So click on OK. So it will apply your respected wind load. Again, I am selecting all the building structure. Go to assign. Again, I am selecting as shell area load, wind pressure coefficient, which is in wind load in Y direction condition. So click on add to existing loads or replace existing load, click on OK. So after adding the load cases, we need to apply the load combinations for this respective structure. Load combination is nothing but the combination of two or more load cases with a suitable value of the factor. Okay, that suitable value of the factor will be available in IS 456 code. Otherwise, we have IS 875 part code. That suitable properties of the factors will be considered as per the tables. Okay, so initially I am selecting define here. So select load combination option here. So here I am selecting default design combinations here. So why? Because I am adding as per the concrete design section. So select the concrete frame design here. Click on OK option. So it will add your default design combinations as 26 options. Click on OK option here. So it will add your respected properties of load combinations here. Now after assigning the load combinations, we need to assign the supports at the base. Okay, so for that initially we need to select this plan view. Again go to the top view. Okay, so it will move your respected object to the downward direction or upward direction depending upon your considerations. So here I am selecting all the base at the ground story for this building. So after that click on assign option, select joint point on the top. So here we need to select the restraints option. So select your fixed supports, click on apply, click on OK. So it will apply your respective fixed supports at the base. So after that we have to add the diaphragm. So initially we need to select all the building for that. So diaphragm is nothing but the center point of the building as well as load action rate. Okay. So for different buildings, there is different types of diaphragm depending upon the geometry of the building. Okay. So click on apply option, nothing but your assign option here. So click on joint. So here we have to select the diaphragms here. So it will be consisting of default diaphragm like from shell object disconnect and D1. So from this, just I am selecting the diaphragm section as D1. Click on apply option here. click on OK. So it will apply your diaphragm for this respected structure, but it is not visible to you respected 3D model. It is only visible to the 2D model. If you want to visible that respected diaphragm for the 3D model, so we have to select the right mark on the right hand side section. So here we have to select the diaphragm extend option in other special items. Click on apply to all windows, click on apply, click on OK. So here you can see diaphragm was applied for this respected structure. Okay, so after assigning the diaphragm, we need to analyze this respected structure as per the seismic loading point of view. So for that, initially we need to click on analyze. So initially we need to check the model for any errors. So now I am selecting the joint checks. It will be consisting of frame checks and shell checks, other checks, fixed one. So in this, just I am selecting only the joint checks if any errors. Otherwise, you can select any one of these respected option for analysis. So click on OK option. Now we have to select the analyze option. So now it is showing the model has been checked, no warning messages here. So after that, go to analyze option. So here we have to select the set load cases to run. So initially we need to select the load cases for that respected building. Now I am selecting all the load cases which is related to the dead loading condition, live loading condition and earthquake loading condition as well as wind loading condition. So click on run now option. So it will run your respected model for analysis process. So after that, I will show you the values which is related to the deflection, shear, bending and everything. Okay. So here my model was analyzed with zero errors. So here my model was analyzed. So initially we need to click on start animation option. Due to presence of the dead loading condition, the building is deflecting like this. So we have to check the deflection for different types of the load cases. So for that, we have to go to display option here. So click on deform shape here. We can select any one of the load case here. So here I am selecting example as earthquake load in X direction. Click on apply, click on OK. So click on start animation option. Now we can see the building is deflecting in X direction condition due to presence of the earthquake load in X direction condition. So after that, click on snap animation. Now we have to see the shear force diagram, bending moment diagram as well as your torsion diagram for this building. So for that, go to click on display option. So select force stresses diagram. So here we have to select the frame pier spandrel forces. So in this we need to select any one of the force. So here I am selecting axial force. Click on apply. Now we can see this is the axial force diagram for this respective structure. Again in the same way we have to select the shear force x direction. So this is the shear force diagram for this structure. Again select the bending moment diagram. So click on apply. So this is the bending moment diagram for this structure. Select the shear 3-3, click on apply. So this is the shear force diagram in y direction condition. Bending moment 3, so click on apply. So this is the bending moment 3. And again I am applying the torsion. Click on apply option. So this is the building torsion for this respective structure. So after checking the diagrams which are related to the shear, bending as well as deflection values, we have to see the tables as well as results. Okay, so for that we have to click on display option. So here we have to select the show tables option. In this we need to select the analysis data results which is related to your respected deflection value, which is nothing but displacement values. So here I am selecting story drift value, let us consider. Again I am selecting reactions, base reaction. Again I am selecting model results which is related to time period and frequency values. Again in the same way just I am selecting frame results for the columns and beams. So after that we have to click on OK option. So it will load the output values which is related to the deflection value, base reactions and everything on the tables here like this. Okay, so you can check the results which is related to this respected part. So here I am selecting base reaction and beam forces. Again I am selecting one more section, column forces. Again I am selecting one more section, model time period and frequency values, Eisen values. Again I am selecting story drift values. So these are the output values for this respected G plus 4 structure. So after analysis process completed, we need to design this respected structure of G plus 4. So this is the important part of building design process in ETIME software. Okay. So as per my considerations, I am designing this respected building as per IS 456 code. So for that, select your design option here. So in this, we need to select the concrete frame design. So here initially we need to select the view preferences option. So it will be consisting of your design code as per the Indian standard system of 456. You can select any one of the code, other code also depending upon your considerations. So as per my assumption, just I am taking it as IS456 code. So again, it will be consisting of some important parameters. You can keep this respected value as it is. You can modify if you know the values of this respected eigenvalues, gamma values and utilization factor limits. Otherwise, you need to keep it as same values. Click on OK. So after that, we have to click on design option here. Again, we have to select the concrete frame design. Now we need to select the rebar section rules for the column section. So select this respected option. So for the column section, it will be consisting of the detailing for non-seismic requirement case and seismic requirement case. So if you are designing any one of the building which is related to the gravity loads only, which is nothing but your dead loading condition, live loading condition, floor loading condition, then you need to consider it as this respected detailing option for non-seismic requirements. Otherwise, if you are want to calculate the respected designing details as per the seismic loading considerations, only you need to consider the right hand side section data. So as per the problem statement, as per the G+4 building design, I was consider the load cases which is related to the earthquake load as well as wind loading condition. So that's why just I am selecting the data which is related to the seismic requirements only. Now we have to select the smallest bar size as well as largest bar size. So here I am selecting the largest bar size is 20. Again I am selecting smallest bar size is 12. So after that we have to select the ties bar size. So here I am selecting ties bar size, smallest is 8 and largest is 10. So after that we have to enter the minimum spacing option. So as per the consideration, we will consider minimum spacing is 50 mm. Again I am selecting the maximum spacing option, just I am taking it as 350. Okay, so click on OK option. So after that we have to select the detailing for the respected column also in the same way. Click on design. So click on concrete frame design. So select the rebar section rules for the respected beams also. Okay, so it is also consisting of two types here, which is related to the non-seismic requirements and seismic requirements. And for this respected building, just I was considered the seismic loading condition, that's why I am taking this. So here we have to select the smallest bar size, just I am considering it as 12 mm bar. Again I am selecting the largest bar size, which is equals to 20 mm bars. Now we have to select the preferred bar size. So preferred bar size, just I am taking it as 16 mm bars. Again we have to enter the number of bars here. So select it as, let us assume it as 4. Again I am selecting it as 4. So after that we have to select the stirrups data. So here I am selecting the stirrups data, smallest bar size is 8 and largest bar size is 10. So again we have to enter the minimum spacing and maximum spacing, just I am taking it as maximum as 150 here. Click on OK option. So after that we need to check the data which is related to the strat design checks for the column and beam sections. So click on design option here. So select the concrete frame design. So here we need to click on strat design checks here. So it will show your respective reinforcement value diagram here like this. So this is the AST requirement for the different members. I will show you this diagram in 3D view. Click on 3D view option. So after that we have to see these respected values as per the reinforcement section of beams and columns. So click on design again. Again we have to select the concrete design. So here I am selecting concrete design. So here we have to click on display design information. Now here we have to select the display design information as per the shear reinforcing section. So it will show your respected beam section and column section, different types of reinforcement section. So after that we have to detail this respected beam design, column design sections. So click on detailing option. Initially we need to select the preferences. So here we have to select the standard units will be in metric system, length will be in meter and section thickness will be in millimeter and rebar spacing will be in millimeter and force will be in kilonewton. So after that we have to select the material quality as per the meter, square meter, cubic meter and ton. So here we have to select the ton values. So here we have to select the ton. So after that click on OK. Okay, so after that we have to click on detailing again. Again we have to click on stat detailing option here. So click on stat detailing option. So it will show your respected designing here like this. So it will design this respected building structure. So I will show you that respected reinforcement values now. So for displaying the information which is related to the beam design section, column design section results, so we have to select this detailing option. So it will be consisting of drawing sheet components and reinforcement cage views. Okay, initially I will explain you that respected detailings. Okay, so this is the diagram after designing of this respected building. It will be showing here like this.
So it will be consisting of your beam sections and beam numbering and center to center distance between the columns. Okay. So this is the length of the building, which is approximately equal to 4 plus 4 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4, which is equals to 17 meter. And width of the building is 3 plus 4, which is equals to 7 meter. Okay. So after that, we have to select the standard details here. So select the list of drawings here. So select the building beam elevation section, 2S section. So this is the 2S section, which is consisting of different types of zones here. You can zoom this. So this is the zone A, zone B, zone C section for the typical beam section. Okay. Again, I am selecting the typical beam section for the 3S section. So this is a 3S section, typical elevation section. Again, it will be consisting of zones here like this, zone A, zone B, zone C. Zone A is nothing but the corner section, and zone C is nothing but the ending point of this respective reinforcement section, and zone B is nothing but the center section, elevation section. So after that, in the same way, we have to select the section which is related to the column beam A. Again, we have to select the section related to the beam B. Again, section related to the beam C. In the same way, just I am selecting the concrete elevation section. Again, it is also consisting of different types of zones and different reinforcement sections. Again, I am selecting column section AA. Okay, so this is the diagram which is related to the column section AA section. So after that, we have to select the beam detailing options here. Okay, we have to check the output values for the detailing of the beams. Okay, so here I am selecting beam detailing, schedule sandbox. Select this concrete section. So it will be consisting of the output file here like this. Okay, so it will be consisting of each and individual section member design results like this. Okay, so this is the Excel sheet, and this is the tabular format we need to take for the designing of any kind of the building. For example, let us consider the beam number 1, which is having a span of 1, and which is having the length of the beam is 2.550 meter and width is 350 cross 350. For longitudinal bars, it is required 2 bars of 20 mm, okay, which is having AST percentage, and AST requirement is 624 mm square at the A section reinforcement. B section, C section, D section will be empty, and F section will be equals to 4 bars of 14 mm dia. Okay, again in the same way, we have to check the stirrups data also. Okay, so this is the stirrups data on the right hand side section. So it is also consisting of zones here as per the considerations. So it will be consisting of the 3 bars of 10 mm dia, 125 center to center distance. For the 2A section, it will be consisting of 16 bars of 10 mm dia and 125 center to center distance for this respected section. Okay, so again in the same way, we have to check the data which is related to the column also. Again, we have to click on column detailing. So click on concrete column, framing plans. So click on this. So this is the framing plan for this respected column section, which is nothing but the center to center distance between the columns. Okay. So again, I'm selecting schedule. Select the concrete column schedule. So here we have to select this respected option. Okay. So it will be consisting of the column number and column size, section, reinforcing and ties, zone A, zone B, zone C section. So it will be consisting of 12 bars of and 14 mm dia. Okay. Which is consisting of the longitudinal section reinforcement for the different types of the stories here. Okay. It will be consisting of the reinforcement values of 12 bars of 22 mm dia at the base. Again, it will be consisting of 12 bars of 14 mm dia at the second story to the third story data and fourth story data, and at the end of the last story, it will be consisting of 12 bars of 14 mm dia for the respected section of CC1 column. In the same way, you can check the data which is related to the CC2 column. Again, it is also consisting of the different types of the reinforcement values at the ground story and at the middle stories, at the top stories. So after that, we have to check the data which is related to the reinforcement cage views. Select this option, select the beams here. So it will be consisting of different types of beams as per the considerations. You can select any one of the beams. Just I'm selecting 4CB1, doubly connect. So it will load your respective reinforcement cage view for this diagram. Okay, so this is the beam design results reinforcement cage view. So it will be consisting of the different properties and different zoning section for the 2S member. Okay, so this is the diagram which is showing for the reinforcement detailing for the beam section. Okay, so this is the beam diagram results. Again, in the same way, we have to select the reinforcement cage view for the column also. Select the column, select any one of the column, select this respected column CC1. So click on this respected option. So this is the data which is related to the CC1. It will be consisting of the reinforcement values for the different floors here, depending upon the considerations and depending upon the output values. So this is also consisting of different types of reinforcement sections. Okay. So as per the considerations, we are taken it as 4 bars. Okay. In each direction, which is equals to 12 number of bars total. Okay. So this is the design results which is related to the column design section. Okay, so from this respected values of the results, we need to take the sheets, drawing sheets. Okay, so select the drawing sheet cover note here. So this is the cover note design results. Again, select general notes option, which is related to the beam sections and column sections. And this is the output file we can give to the customers. Okay, so in the same way, we have to select the flooring framing plans. Okay. Select the floor framing plans. So this is the floor framing plans. Again, select the column scheduling details. So this is the column scheduling details values. Again, select the beam scheduling details. So this is the beam scheduling details and column layout section diagram. So this is the column layout section diagram. Okay. So after that, we have to check the report here. Okay. Select the report here, double click on it. So click on project summary report. Okay. So it will load your respective project summary report table here. Okay. Which is consisting of all your design summary which is related to the G+4 building. So select this respected options, select any one of the page. It will be consisting of your all your calculation part which is related to this respected building design process. Okay. So this is the process designing of G+4 building by using ATAP software. If you have any queries about this respected video, please text me your questions in the below comment box. I will give you the answers for that respected questions. Thank you.